Hello, in this video I want to talk a little bit about the user profile and user settings in ChartMill. After all, this is the way to fully customize a number of features in ChartMill to your personal profile and ensure an even better user experience. So let's get started right away. On the top right, click on your account name and then click on My Account. This will take you to your profile page where you can change your username and email address if you would prefer to do so. With the tabs below, you can change various settings. Notifications. In this section, you can manage which mails and alarms you wish to receive by checking or unchecking the corresponding box. Click on the button Manage Your Alerts and a pop-up window will appear with all your active alerts. Alarms that are no longer needed can be deleted here. How to set alarms is shown in this video, and there is also an article available. I'll put a link in the description below. Chart settings. This will give you an overview of all your currently saved chart settings. Open the one you use the most and select those saved settings as default. Now, each time you open a chart in the stock charts or in the stock screener, these chart settings will be shown by default. I have selected my swing trading view as default settings. This is a set to a daily chart for a period of 4 months with a number of moving average as overlay. Next, you set another chart settings as secondary default. As for myself, I have the long-term view as secondary default. For this, I use weekly candles over a relatively long period and the ChartMill trend indicator is shown as an overlay. This is useful if you wish to see two charts simultaneously. For example, if I select two charts as view on the stock charts or stock screener page, the first chart will show my default settings and the second chart will show my secondary default settings. And because my default view is set to a daily view and my secondary default to a weekly view, you'll immediately see the daily chart next to the weekly chart, which is very useful to have an instant view of the short and long-term trend. Screener settings. As with the chart settings, you'll find your previously saved filter screens in here. Click on the arrow on the far right to rename or delete specific screens. One of the screens shown here can be set as default, and as soon as you open the stock screener page, the default screen will be loaded. For example, I have set my breakout screen above the 52-week high and high volume as default, which is automatically shown every time I open the stock screener page. And if you want to switch screens quickly, click on this map icon and select one of your other screens from the list. In this video, I show you how to create and save your first screens. View settings. The view settings determine which of the available views on the stock charts or stock screener page are shown by default. Both for the charts as for the screener, you can set these separately. Suppose, for example, that for the stock charts view, you want to see standard charts. You select for the default view charts. If I select the technical analysis table for the stock screener view and I subsequently visit the stock screener page, the default TA table view will be shown with the ChartMill setup quality, technical rating, ChartMill relative strength, etc. If you prefer to see fundamental ratios, select the fundamental analysis table in the view settings. The default screen in a stock screener will now change to fundamental analysis table. The view is also in tables, but ChartMill will now show first the fundamental rating with next to it dividend yield, price earnings ratio, forward price earnings ratio, and so on. Watchlists. This is where you can check all your created watchlists. You can open them from here, remove individual tickers from the watchlist, or choose a different name. You can also delete the watchlist completely. How to create a watchlist was covered in this video. The position sizing settings. You will find this tool on the chart in both the stock charts and stock screener. You open the tool by clicking on the ruler icon in the top right corner of the blue bar. The tool will open in a separate pop-up window. Click in the chart for which you want to use the tool. The tool provides information on how many shares you can and may buy in relation to your available trading capital and the risk involved. More info on using the tool can be found in a separate article, which I'll put a link in the description below. The default settings of the tool are visible at the top. This includes the trading capital, risk percentage, and the costs, consisting of commission and eventually taxes. You can change these default values based on your personal situation. As an example, I'm going to set the capital at $25,000 and set the risk percentage to 1%. Next, I click on Update Settings. As soon as I open the Position Sizing tool, these will be the default values for the specific fields. Credit info. This screen gives you more information about the number of credits still available in your account and how many credits you have already used. This is not important if you have a paying membership, as you can see on my screen. Login types. You can log into ChartMill in three different ways: through a regular email address and password, through Facebook, or through a StockTwits account. You can see which logins are active. And change password. Should you wish to change your password, this is the page to go to. So this concludes the user account profile and settings video. Be sure to make use of these settings to customize ChartMill for your specific use. Thanks for watching. See you next time.